SBR Forum's Inside the Lines is brought to you by Ladbrokes.
We are previewing the College Bowls here at SBR Forum Videos. I'm Peter Loshak. We're talking right now with Joe Duffy from OffshoreInsiders.com. Joe, thanks so much for doing this call with us.
Peter, thank you for having me. As I said on one of our other videos, one of my absolute favorite times of the year, my family's being alienated, but they don't like me that much anyway. So I'm going to work hard to pick winner after winner at OffshoreInsiders.com.
All right. Tell us a little bit about yourself. Take about 10 or 15 seconds to tell us who Joe Duffy is and why it's such a great thing that we have you on these shows.
I am an OC, as you say, an original capper. I go back to the 1980s, the score phone days. Got my start in this business by doing a 900 number, the amazing Cadillac Club on the score phones. When the internet came along, I joined that. So I've been in this industry full time as a handicapper. And the only other part of my job has ever been also as a score phone announcer, but in the sports handicapping business full time, literally since the 1980s. And, you know, I think I've learned a few things over the years and have been pretty good at it. And I'm going to work hard to have another successful bowl season.
Absolutely. Joe Duffy from Offshore Insiders, original Kappa. Music City Bowl is what we're going to talk about right now. North Carolina State and Vanderbilt. Vanderbilt's a 6.5 or 7-point favorite, and I guess, you know, this game is being played in Tennessee, so I guess you might say that Vanderbilt has a home field edge or should be given a home field advantage on the line. The total is 52, and North Carolina State, you know, they're going through a coaching change. It's a little bit of an afterthought for them. They were also not that great of a bet against the spread on the year, while Vanderbilt was a good one, 8-4 against the spread. Both teams were also small undertrenders during the regular season. And, you know, North Carolina State's strength was their passing game, but good pass defenses were able to hold them down this year. So I'm thinking that maybe they might, with a new coach, they might run a bit more. And, you know, this game might resemble the Florida State game a bit, which only went to 33. So I'm thinking maybe the under 52 might be a good bet. What do you think?
Well, they actually are going to use their lame duck coaching staff. Mm-hmm. We'll be coaching in that final game. The coach they hired, Dorian, will not be coaching in this contest. But right. A lot of the stuff you said, again, I agree with 100% that Vanderbilt, this is definitely a home game for them. And we've actually had a few Vanderbilt games this year where we've picked them. And as I've said all along, you don't even have to possibly worry about Vanderbilt's motivation. They are a brand new power. They used to be the weaklings of the SEC. Even people like me said they didn't belong in the SEC. They should drop down to the ACC or some other conference. Well, they've proven us wrong each of the last 2 years. They've been one heck of a team. This is, for them, no question a major. Well, any bowl is a major bowl for them, much less the fact that they are playing a home bowl game. Also, over the years, another one of our theories that's proven fruitful is teams from power conferences, which generally means the SEC and the Big 12 in previous years, you know, 10, 15 years ago, it meant the Big 10, and there can be other, you know, the Pac-10 occasionally is that. But when a team is a middle rung from a power conference, we found they generally do well in bowl games in part because they benefit from the rest. A team like Vanderbilt that doesn't have as much depth as some of the powers of the conference, they can wear down as the year goes on, but they've got that frontline talent, and they're the ones that are going to benefit greatly from this rest. Also, Vanderbilt's a great Peter Principle team. With the teams they've lost to, they've lost to very good teams, South Carolina, Florida, and Georgia, which are the three best teams in their division. But teams that they were better than. Now, they also lost to Northwestern, to decent teams, but teams that they were better than, they crushed. They have 5 wins this year by 23 or more points, and in fact, 5 of their covers were by 11.5 points. So Vanderbilt, to superior teams, they lose. To inferior teams, they beat pretty soundly. So the fact that, as I said, as a new power, they're playing in a huge bowl game for them. Essentially, it is a home game, and they're going against a team that has a lame duck coaching staff. It all points towards a blowout here.
Oh, great analysis, Joe Duffy. And we will give you a 6.5 because that is a widely available line right now. It's 6.5 or 7. So if you're taking Vanderbilt and you're going to tail Joe Duffy, definitely grab 6.5 where you can. Great preview. Thanks so much, Joe.
Thank you. And you are right. It is very important to shop for lines as
yes,
well.
Yes,